Hey everybody, welcome back to Pixel Junkies. We're playing Republic Commando. Laugh? What?
It's like Winnie the Pooh.
Hey, it's a new gun!
It is a new gun.
Yeah, it's a Trandoshan ACP repeater.
Cool iron sights.
PCP repeater?
ACP.
Oh. Seriously, what is up with those iron sights?
You gotta... I don't know.
There aren't
Get
any.
One of your guys That's in that sniping position immediately.
Aaron, just aim that gun.
He can't.
Oh.
Doesn't have iron sights.
It's a cool gun.
Need more firepower to take it out. Just throw grenades at it.
It's down. As soon as that mine is deactivated, get one of your guys on that immediately.
Oh.
It's up again.
I love that it's like a tank you get in. Like literally a tank of something. Tank of water, fish tank. Oh, yeah,
alright, get one of your guys zipped. In it.
Adam, what started the Clone Wars?
Jesus.
You really want to know?
Absolutely.
Alright, so the Clone Wars was started because after the last Jedi Sith Wars, which happened 1,000 generations ago, when they say for over 1,000 generations, the Jedi have been the Guardians of Peace and... Guardians of Peace and whatever the other he says in the galaxy.
Yeah.
That's because it has been around 1,000 years since the last Jedi Sith Wars, in which the Sith were all but wiped out, and the Jedi kind of were able to maintain peace throughout the galaxy.
Yeah, it was Darth Bane.
No.
Yeah, and that's where Darth Bane came from in the Rule of Two. So 1,000 years went by, and the Republic, you know...
1,000 years or 1,000 generations?
No.
Obi-Wan says 1,000 generations. It's around 1,000 years.
Nice math there, Obi-Wan.
Let's yeah, well...
Get your guys on the turrets.
You mean you didn't have a kid when you were one?
And then he had a kid when he was
yeah.
one.
Yeah. That's weird, man.
So the Jedi are, anyway, the Republic is getting, it starts decreasing the size of its army until it's only a minor peacekeeping force, and they keep relying more and more on Jedi to be the mitigators of peace, and they send Jedi, into deal with conflict situations. But the Republic is getting more and more bloated.
Fuck this gun.
What?
This gun sucks.
It's a concussion rifle, LJ-40.
Yep. Sounds like it doesn't do anything.
It fires and it takes a minute to explode, but it does explode. It does a lot of damage. Anyway. So the Republic was getting bloated, and they were trying to increase more taxes, and it was just becoming way too corrupt. And the, have you destroyed that thing yet? Sorry, I'm
Maybe.
Trying to do, like,
this
three
thing?
Things. No, you get, turn around. One of your guys is not in the, is not on one of the turrets, I'm pretty sure.
I told them both to go on it.
A bunch of the, galaxy's largest, trade and commerce organizations, like the Commerce Guild, the Trade Federation, the Techno Union, that kind of stuff.
Uh-huh.
They formed together and they wanted to break away from the Republic, as well as a lot of outer rim and mid rim planets who no longer wanted to deal with the Republic's corruption anymore. But the conflicts and separatist movements were becoming more and more, and there weren't enough Jedi to deal with this. Naboo was kind of the final straw because it showed the people that the Republic wasn't really up to the task of defending planets anymore. The Trade Federation invasion of Naboo.
The separatist
and secretly, all this was being orchestrated by Darth Sidious, Emperor Palpatine, in order to don't go.
My things. Hey, look, it's the ship Anakin blew up.
Yeah. It's the same one.
You should try spinning. That's a good trick.
Oh, my God. I watched that movie the other day.
All right. Now...
Not good.
You mentioned that, like...
Okay.
Probably 2 weeks from now.
I watched that movie 2 weeks and a couple days ago.
Aaron.
Yeah.
As you're... Listen to what I'm saying when you're going to the next section, because it's very important.
Jake
when you go to the next section, there's going to be a droid dispensers are going to start coming through the force field. When you're not going to be able to do it right away, but you're going to want to put a breaching start as soon as the option comes available. You're going to want to put a breaching charge near the force field regulator in order to damage it, so it will destroy the droid dispensers coming through. In the meantime, get all of your guys to set up as many traps and stuff in the next room as they can. Because it'll honestly
help
you.
Set up traps.
I'll show you. All right. Okay, first off, turn to your left of me and put a breaching charge on that thing. That's going to reveal a turret for you guys. Now, walk over around those boxes. Okay, put a one there. And then put... keep going. Not there. Yeah, put a... Get them to put a mine there. And you see that... that one there. Put order one of them to put something there. Now, basically all those little canister things, you're going to want to put a little proximity mine there.
Okay.
Now, turn around again. Don't detonate that right away. Turn around back to the turret. Detonate that one first in the you're looking at.
This one?
Yeah. And order one of your guys to get in the turret, and then detonate the one that it's to your immediate left. That gives it a clear line of fire.
Nice job!
And then get two of your guys to get on grenade... one guy, put him on a grenade attachment right there. Or sniping position, and to your left, get the other guy on a grenade attachment. Or grenade position. And you gotta run over and try and take out that droid dispenser.
Oh, alright. Change of weapons. Oh, yeah, yeah, forget. Oh.
Good game.
I wanted to do iron sights, but I heard this gun doesn't have any.
Alright. So the Republic... Too many taxes on the Republic.
Yes.
So a bunch of people wanted to
Does
leave.
Does this guy die from this, or what?
The Bloc Quebec wall wanted to leave.
Shoot those... turn your left. Shoot those. There. Okay.
Continue. So they became separatists.
Yes. And they were secretly being funded by... get one of your guys to put a breaching charge on that. And you put a breaching charge on the SPD turret. One. Or a detonator, sorry. So Emperor Palpatine is secretly funding both sides. He wants the Separatists to break away so that he can cause a great big war, which will eventually stretch the Jedi too thin throughout the galaxy, in which he can use his clone troopers that he's an army he's been secretly developing for years. Look to your left. You see that detonator I had you place? Detonate that.
Yay.
Didn't do anything. I rid of my shotgun for this.
Look to your left. As soon as he's done, you're going to want to detonate that bomb. Detonate it now, quickly. Oh, now it's too late. The last droid dispenser made it through.
What does that mean?
Well, now no more droid dispensers can make it through this hangar. But you still got to deal with this one that's left.
Oh, okay.
And the one that just came through. You're going to want to turn around and get one of your guys on that.
Where did it come from?
It came from outer space, and it went behind you. See?
Oh.
Hmm. Alright. Led by Sidious.
Yeah, and so they get a bunch of planets who want to leave. They form a coalition of 1,000 different systems that are all kind of bankrolled by the big economic trade groups like the Trade Federation and the Techno Union and stuff like that, the banking clan. They want to break away from the Republic and start their own separatist government that has limited government oversight and control. Basically, a liberal state. They're basically American Tea Party. The Republic doesn't want systems to break away, so Palpatine secretly created the manipulated Jedi into creating the clone army to act as a military force to fight against the Separatists and their droid army.
So how did he do that? How did he manipulate the Jedi into making the clones?
He told Jedi Master Sifo Dyas that the Jedi would not be enough in order to safeguard the Republic, and they needed a military. And the only way to get a military in secret was to clone one. That would be the best option. Hmm. Did you ever play the game Bounty Hunter? Star Wars Bounty Hunter?
I played a bit of it, yeah.
That game deals with Count Dooku figuring out which bounty hunter he's going to use as the template for his the clone army.
Star Wars has so many good games.
Yeah. All right, there's... Okay.
More good games and good movies.
Keep going. In this room here...
I agree, even though I like almost all the movies.
There's going to be two droid dispensers already down in this hangar.
Okay.
So I get one of your guys to...
do that?
Yeah. Now keep going to your left. Through that door. We've got to
get down to that force field regularly. I'm going to heal first.
You don't have time.
I don't have time.
Just keep going.
All
your
right.
guys will follow you.
Yeah, you butthole.
Alright, well, fuck you.
Those dudes are, like, beelining it, like, away from you.
Yeah. Just forget him. Forget him.
Why are they going past?
Okay.
What's happening?
You're, all right, you're timed right here.
Now, get one. See the force field regulator on your left hand side? Get one of your. Left. Right there. The blue thing. Turn around.
This thing?
Yeah. Get one of your guys to detonate that. Now. On the. Forget about them. They don't matter. Now, to your right on the other side of that pillar, do you see this? Do you see the speeder?
Yeah. Yep.
Hack those controls. Yeah, should be right there.
That's a big old speeder bike, that is.
Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on.
Because the speeder will activate and destroy that door dispenser for you.
Cool.
It's like a puzzle.
Yay!
Wait for it.
Cool.
That's kind of cool.
Is the force field regulator,
Nope.
Good job, man. Good job, Republic Commandos, doing what you're told.
Did you have you told one of them to detonate? Or?
Yeah, he definitely did. Yeah,
it's got a timer on it.
And you got to get one of your guys on the SPD dispenser.
Fire in the hole, sir. There you go. Work fast.
Let's move on to the last. Oh, I don't have any grenade thingies. What about there? We go. Aren't these?
Anyway,
okay.
Clone army is created.
Yeah.
The rest is in the movies, pretty much.
Yeah.
The Banking Clan will sign your treaty.
Yeah.
Grenade didn't do anything. Oh yeah, great. Gotta do it myself. Man, that was a long second. Freaking hell. You guys right, can't
no
talk,
more,
you know.
No more droids can come to us. So just finish off these ones and you should be good to go. You have the EMPs. Anyway, what were you saying?
I wasn't saying anything.
That
I
was
finished.
It. We found out that all the rest of the stuff was exposed.
Now, this is obviously, there's a lot more to it than what I'm just saying, but...
I don't think there is. I think you laid it out pretty much word for word from the movies.
It's better explained in the canon than it ever was in the movies, which is a major failing of those films.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. There's like...
Oh, yeah?
There's a lot of stuff to cover.
Other movies have covered a lot more in way less time, though.
There is a lot of stuff to cover, but the first movie covers so little.
That's what the first movie should have been, is about setting that up, and it really doesn't.
Yeah, I agree with that, yeah.
It's about...
But I think most of the other movies were... did about what they should have done.
I think your other guy's up there. Where you left them.
I think if the first movie had been different, it would have set up the second one a lot better. I think the real failing there was the Phantom Menace.
Attack of the Clones really was not good either.
it
was not.
No,
it was better. It was better.
Yeah, it was better.
But I think the problem with Attack of the Clones was not having been set up very well from the first movie. I think that was probably the flaw there.
Yeah,
lore wise,
right.
At least.
Wait, where's your other guy to?
He exploded, don't worry.
Oh, no, they got him.
Because then they had to do pretty much all that.
So,
like,
heal up your guys and then turn around to your right. Or left now. Left. Left. Keep turning left. Keep turning left. There, ammo.
Like, all that stuff that Adam is saying, like...
You basically
they had
said
to do...
turn left until you could have just turned right a little bit.
I told you to turn right, you turn left.
Oh, they
like,
said
way
turn
too
left.
Much of that stuff was left till the second movie.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So they didn't have enough time to explain it in the second movie. If the first movie had been better, it would have, and I don't mean had been a better movie, I mean had just been better lore-wise.
Where the fuck are these guys coming from?
Like, near... They're in the fourth hangar, Hangar D, and they're just pouring through.
You guys didn't just learn how to heal up on your own. One of you did. Oh. Yeah, send one guy at
a time.
One
of the things I always liked about the Star Trek movies is that they kind of assume you've seen all the TV. Or at least the ones before the most recent J.J. Abrams retellings.
Right.
Well,
fuck that invisible wall.
Like, they...
Alright, head to that door.
I wanted to get the ammo over here.
They don't overburden themselves with exposition in those? Mm-hmm. Okay, I kind of admire that.
That's
really brave.
That's cool. If you're doing a movie that expands on the TV show,
yeah,
do that.
Exactly, yeah. Do Star Wars is a little different, of course.
But, like, through that whole first movie, they could have left out, like, 85% of all the Anakin stuff. And it would have been a much better movie because of it, in my opinion.
Yeah.
Load screen.
Okay. Now, here's what you gotta do. Don't bother with that sniper attachment. Or sniper position. When you get into the next hangar, there's gonna be way too many droid dispensers already down to deal with. When you head to the door into the hangar, take an immediate left, head to the back of the hangar, get one of your, okay. There's going to be a big, empty spot in the, but don't breach that charge yet. Or don't open the door yet. There's going to be a, on your immediate left, there's going to be, at the very back of the hangar, there's going to be like a big blank space. Get two of your guys to take up sniping positions in that space. Damn. On the very farthest away from you on the right, if you're facing away into the back of the hangar, there's going to be a console. You got to get one of your guys to hack that console. And then there's going to be a turret on the left that you can get in and start pounding away at enemies.
Aaron's not listening.
Are you listening?
It's some of it's getting through.
Okay. Breach.
Alright.
Dies immediately.
Oh, this game's impossible. Nobody's helping me.
I'm quick saving.
Wait. No, never mind.
Sweet.
Further along, I guess.
There we go. That's this one.
Don't use your grenade attack.
This is like oddly specific instructions.
Oh yeah, stand in front of me. Good idea. You shooting? All right.
Get your guys to put proximity mines on there quickly.
Yeah, Aaron. Be quicker.
And get one of your guys to get on that sniping position behind you.
Let's set a trap there. Setting charge. Let's use this clear line of fire.
Into position. Just stay down there on your own, Sam. Wilson.
They're
coming back. Position,
sir. Okay. And wait.
Moving to cover. Waiting. Commence waiting.
So, do any of these guys? No, shit. Do any of these guys die in the books?
The droid guys or the Republic commandos?
Commandos.
Yes, clearly the droid guys.
I'm not gonna say.
Why?
Because you should read them. Throw an EMP.
I was gonna say yes.
Read the book, Andrew.
But it's Karen Travis, literally the worst author in existence. I'm only joking.
Andrew just said that to bother Adam, for the listeners who don't know how much Adam really enjoys the work of Karen Travis.
Yes, thank you, Roy. Observation noted.
It
was needed, Aaron.
Was it?
It was needed exposition.
I don't think so.
I don't think you're needed exposition.
Well, I'm playing the game, so yeah.
Stop expositioning.
You know what my favorite part about me is? I can be at home and not have to deal with construction noises all the time in my room. Because if I had to deal with that, I'd be a pretty sorry state.
This is something else nobody gets.
It's because
they're doing construction.
For the people at home,
exposition.
Andrew's an asshole.
I am. I'm not going to argue with you.
Oh.
That was a very insightful comment. And I thank you for...
Head left immediately.
For your honesty.
Don't stop. Just keep going.
This is the hangar Adam was talking about.
Do you see that big blank space in the back of the wall? Okay, yeah. You fucked yourself here. You can't get through there. Trust me.
Fuck you, game. Could clearly crawl under that. Everyone stick to cover. Oh.
Okay, one guy on the grenade attachment, one guy in that console to your left.
Oh, I thought this was a sniping position.
It is a sniping position.
Oh, this thing.
It all is.
Turn around to your left. See that console? Get one of your guys to hack that.
30 seconds.
Yeah. Jesus. But then something pretty fucking cool is gonna happen when he hacks that.
This clairvoyance is great.
Is that the Enterprise outside?
No,
yeah.
It's...
Am I the only one who thinks it looks kind of like
the
Enterprise from the side?
I'd use your grenade attachment on that droid to go.
Why the hell were there kids on the Enterprise?
Because it wasn't a military vessel. Yeah. With a
fucking thing. Oh, they're all goddamn
exploration
dead.
Vessel.
That's yeah. exactly right.
But
yeah.
why were there kids on the exploration move. Vessel?
Well,
because they had families. They wanted to start. They were going to cause and start a new colony. They wanted to have kids there.
Jesus.
The Enterprise's purpose is to go out and colonize.
Yeah.
Oh.
Is you?
Well,
Connor,
it's
no, gone. I don't know yeah, if I would say that.
Gone.
They're dead.
Well, then don't be.
Oh, good advice. Tactical brilliance.
All you have to do to win the game is not die, Aaron. I don't know why
you're... dies in front of the healing thing.
He's getting ringed apart by a destroyer droid.
Yeah, he healed himself right. too much.
Tell one of your guys to get in the defensive positions there.
Where?
Okay.
One of them's in the gun.
The sniping position and the grenade position.
But no, there really should not have been kids on the Enterprise. This is a bad idea if you could... Like, finding an ideally, there would not be kids on the Enterprise.
Get 6-2 on the grenade position. No, don't even bother with that.
Oh, no?
No. Because that's going to take care of itself. Very shortly.
There were no kids on the Defiant, though. That's good.
No.
It was a military vessel.
Exactly, yeah.
But see,
turn around. To your left. To your left. Left! Get in that.
This?
Yes.
It just so happened that they got into a lot of, craziness.
Now, fucking wreck shit. Alright. Sorry.
I'm assuming there's other galaxy-class or other exploration vessels that have a much more boring time of it, like the Melbourne or something.
Was the Melbourne a galaxy-class?
No, it wasn't. But it was another exploration vessel.
Well, can you imagine if they had kids on the Odyssey, the ship that was reamed the perp of the Dominion?
Yeah. And the Melbourne ended up getting smashed by the Borg.
Was it?
Yeah, in the Best of Both Worlds Part 1.
Right.
Because Riker was going to join the Melbourne. Card, she's a fine ship, and like later on in that episode, we see the Melbourne like ripped into 85 pieces.
Do you see the blue?
It's like, oh yeah, it's a killer.
Here's the thing. The Melbourne gets boarded by some hostile species that want information on humanity and Earth.
Yeah.
To destroy humanity and Earth. Melbourne gets captured, and... Some guys threatened to give up the secrets or they blow up the Melbourne. And he's like, you know what? It's military. I'm serving humanity by not saying anything. Fine. Melbourne blows up, but no secrets are leaked. The Enterprise gets boarded. It's like, tell us your secrets or we murder your family. It's like, you're no longer protecting your species at that point. You're saving your family. If the Enterprise blows up, your entire life, your entire family is gone.
I know what you
so
mean.
So why, it seems like a liability to take your entire family along with you on this voyage that you're likely not to come back from.
Although, as many times as the Enterprise has gotten into trouble, it never started out bad. It's always like, on our way to see some new weather formations of this planet. It's like, it totally seemed like an innocuous voyage.
And then they run into like a crystalline entity. It's like, oh god!
You remember when they got swallowed by Nagilum, the giant cat entity?
don't remember that.
He has like a face that reminds me of a cat face. And he just, like, he's like a hole in space. And he just swallows them up. He's like, I'm Nagilum. Kill that guy. And he kills them. And he's like, now I know what death looks like for people. Bye.
Oh, I do remember that.
In, like, season 2 or something.
God. Remember in one of the movies where the Enterprise almost gets blown apart? And it does get blown apart? And, like, yeah. Or one of them. And then you see, like, the... half of the Enterprise is exposed to space, and you see all the children fly out into space and die? Remember that part?
No.
Bringing back sociopath Andrew.
Save everybody.
Yeah, see, that's dumb.
I remember there is a hole blown in the Enterprise in Generations.
Yeah. Andrew, if they want to get blown out into space, that's their thing.
Hey, I'm not judging them. If they want to live their life in space, that's fine.
Cortana has to say something. Aaron, that hallway to your right that's got turrets, each of the alcoves has two turrets facing into the hallway. You're going to have to destroy both of them to progress, and I think there's like 3 sections of turrets each. To the room to your left, there's going to be ammo and aid stations in there.
Cortana's really let herself go.
The ship AI is actually kind of sexy now. It was like, battle droids.
Oh, you only have
offline.
2 minutes,
buddy. What?
No, I'm just joking.
I didn't hear what you said.
No, I said you only have 2 minutes.
Okay.
In the grand tradition of this game.
Okay, imagine in Halo 5, Chief recovers Cortana, but she's got a different voice.
No.
She's got all the same memories, but she sounds like me.
Oh, I would have went with,
no,
like,
she would
Rooker
sound like this. Chief! Chief! The Covenant are coming! Chief! What are you doing? No, put my chip back in, Chief! Chief!
Michael Rooker.
Hey, Chief! Destroy Halo! Yeah.
You mean,
Freaking Christ. Get out of the way! You stupid asshole.
Yeah, but he sounds like Michael Rooker.
It says ship hull integrity 75%. Does that mean I'm fucked?
I don't think that means anything, but you might be.
Well, if I can fuck it up, I will.
Get rid of those shields. That
that was a flashbang.
I know. I don't have anything else.
In that room in there is ammo. To your left.
This fucking gun is useless.
To your left.
I'll
in that room.
This thing.
Yeah. In here.
Yeah, there's a lot of ammo.
And hell. You know that room I said that had a lot of ammo and health in it? The room with a lot of ammo.
Yeah,
and health.
I thought it was the little nub there. I thought there might have been some boxes, but clearly not.
Yeah, no, it's the other room with all the ammo and health in it.
Yeah, I got it. Thanks, asshole.
Okay.
Watch out for the turret on your left there. 7, 8, 40. Be right back. You got that one.
You remember the turrets in Fallout 3? They were really good.
You got. I think you have EMPs now.
As far as turrets go.
Yeah, I mean, in terms of turrets in video games, they didn't ruin them in Fallout.
Yeah, those are some of my favorite turrets, actually.
They certainly weren't turrets in video games.
Get one of your guys to heal up 6-2. Or, 4-0.
Where is he?
He's on the ground behind you. Ready for action, sir. Oh, he's gone.
The fuck? Oh.
You're basically running the gauntlet to sniper. Oh, get your guys on those sniping positions. And take out those turrets, or they will ream your guys apart.
Stuck in a box.
You're doing very well.
I'm
he's
not
still
in.
Oh, Aaron.
He's doing better than
EMP.
He was.
Hit what?
EMP.
Oh, fuck.
At the SPDs.
I think he's like hit G or something. Like,
yeah, hit G.
How do you know what G does?
Activates God mode.
That's all you had to do. It's a good thing you haven't cheated before in this series.
Can you imagine if you were look like what's a, like? Can you imagine if you looked at like Dark Souls controls on like computer and it's just like, and you just see like a computer like a keyless snake hand, and it's just like win game, and you press it. And
Dark Souls is really problematic on the PC with the controls.
I'm not sure.
You piece of shit.
I'm not sure it's compatible with keyboard at all.
Do you have
actually.
Any grenade attacks?
It is. It's
left?
Just really weird. I think it's the general consensus on that. That game was made to be played with a controller.
Oh yeah, it was.
Can you not use a controller on the...
Oh, you can.
Apparently you can, but it's not...
Alright, you gotta head to that door, just push through.
You can use a controller on the PC for it, because the regular PC controls would be...
Let's move on.
Yeah, it's like a...
Pull away your gun, man.
I think
I'm
those are like famously bad. I'm not positive about that.
I toss a grenade.
Everyone I know who's played it has used a controller.
Oh yeah, bounce
good
it
job,
back.
Good job, dude. Just stand right there.
Okay. Bounce back.
When you get up to the top, head right immediately
away.
Up that ramp.
When you get up to the top,
there's gonna be 3 computer consoles there. Get each of your guys to hack one of them. You're gonna activate the gun batteries on the ship in order to destroy the Trade Federation ship. No, don't put them there. You gotta get them to hack. Or you won't. Or you'll be out of run out of time.
Where's the?
It'll happen in a second. Yeah.
Oh,
there
we go. Okay.
There you go.
Or you can hack the one in the middle and leave him sniping.
Yeah, you hack that one.
Because that would be more interesting.
Sweet video.
I'm very impressed that you managed to do this. This actually is very probably the hardest
coffee
part of the game.
Coffee break. Hardest part of the game?
Yep.
Is that
unimpressive.
Coffee in a glass cup thing?
Jesus, Rory, I'm sorry to break it to you like this, but you can't put coffee in a glass.
No,
bowl.
You can't.
Some fucking monster.
But like, is
what
that thick enough for the like? Because I've done that before, where I poured coffee into a glass and literally shattered.
Sure, so you can do whatever you want with your sexual lives. What? I don't care. That was mainly to make fun.
Look, we're not trying to judge anybody.
Man, I can't...
If you want to live your life, because
like,
it'd
be great to
mug.
See all the action going on
one
behind
of the
me.
Is mugs are really thick, right? And like that's
yeah, the
like
ceramic...
they withstand the heat.
It's not
right?
a glass; it's a mug.
Yep. Oh, okay,
it's a,
yeah.
It's a mug.
It has a handle.
I thought it was like an ordinary mug. Glass.
Maybe it does have too much mug. Come on.
Yeah.
Sorry to miss all the action, guys.
Was that hot coffee, though?
Not anymore, really.
Yeah, that's what I was asking. Because you had that when I came in, like, an hour and a half ago.
Yeah, I don't mind cold coffee.
Oh.
I prefer hot, but...
You ever have the Tim Hortons, like, iced coffee?
Jesus. Yep, confusies.
This situation will take care of themselves in about 30 seconds.
No, it's actually iced coffee mix over there if you want that they use, I think.
Oh. With ice cubes in it.
Yeah, it also has ice cubes in it, I think, yeah.
I use this if I get pinned down. Assume snipe position, Delta. What's going on? It's the battleship.
There.
It's the battleship. You sunk my battleship, yeah?
I tried to make iced tea the other day.
How'd
huge disaster.
Did I bet Roy starts pouring drinks. He's just like, mean that this guy gets off the pitches of little girls and pigtails?
Did you put a tea bag in ice water?
What? No. I actually, like, made iced tea.
What do you mean you made iced tea? Oh.
What? No,
he made tea and then put ice in it.
Now we're about a third of the way through the game.
Okay. Sweet. It's only 1,000 episodes.
Oh, we got a third left, sir. Oh. 2/3.
Oh. So what did you... How did you make iced tea, Rory?
What you do is you put, like, water in, like, a like
oh, I didn't
pot.
Start the timer. Or it's over. I didn't feel it. I don't know how long this episode is.
It's long.
Is it?
Yeah.
All right.
Come on back next time when Rory explains how he made
iced tea. No, explain it really quick. Right. The abridged version.
Explain it now.
Yeah, basically, you put water in a pot, you boil the pot, you take, like, 3 bags of preferably black tea... And, you, like, let it hover in the pot, like, inside the water for about 5 minutes, and then you chill it, and you
let
put ice
it hover?
In it. Like, you...
So you do literally make tea and then put ice in it?
More or less, yeah.
Hmm.
And then you add sugar.
Yeah.
And right. Water to dilute it.
All right, well, come back next time. Go. Make sure you go try out that Rory's special tea, iced tea recipe. For the best iced tea.
Oh man, this is NSFW right there.
It's just a holograph of some guy nailing.
You can see the dick going through because it's a little hologram.
Mm. He's having sex with the with the projector. So you just see the dick ramming it. It's just a holograph of a dick.
See you next time, everyone.
And then he like bends over and it's just all leaks out.